else but New York? Who else would have the balls to declare themselves the greatest city in the world? And then to market it that way and print that on mugs and t-shirts and then to sell those things to people who arrive and they buy them and take them back to their lesser cities. Who else but New York would be so crass? It's almost exactly like fucking Paris Hilton. Because when you're fucking Paris Hilton, you're fucking her. You're fucking her and you're thinking, oh my God, I'm fucking Paris Hilton. And that realization takes you out of the moment. You can never fully be in that moment because you're thinking about what that moment signifies. And Paris Hilton, what's Paris Hilton thinking? Paris Hilton is thinking, oh my God, I'm Paris Hilton. And that's New York. Hey, do any of you people who are leaving want to stay and talk about this, or do you want to run out like cowards? Do you want to stay and talk about this like adults that you came to my show to see, or do you want to walk out like cowards? Because I can refrain from using language when talking to you, but I'd like you to use the English language to talk to me. You insulted my show, you poured water on my art, you messed up my things here. Do you all intend to just walk out of here? Hey, ma'am, you appear to be an adult. Would you like to stay and talk about this? Are you guys leaving? Is there anyone that would like to speak to what? Ma'am, please take a message back to your people. In the future, find out what you're going to see before you see it. When you decide to protest, do it to my face! Are you with this group? We don't have to. We were talking already. We were having a conversation. We're having this show. Okay. Thank you.
All right.
That's crazy. Hey, can we go into like a little brighter queue? Maybe the top queue of the show or something. Something a little brighter for a second. Well, you know, it's interesting because the run has been going pretty well. The numbers have been building, and then today they were like, it's sold out. And I thought, wow, that's fantastic. And they said, I was really excited. I was like, damn, that's just really compelling. We're sold out. And I was really excited because, you know, you like to think that you're doing something, you're reaching people, you know. It's hard doing live theater, doing a live event, reaching people. So it's difficult, you know. And so I was very, very excited. And they said, like, there's two high school groups. And I was like, two high school groups? Very exciting. And because I really believe the future of live performance is people in high school. You know, like, without reaching new people, there's no point at all, you know. Like, I'm getting older. Some of us out there are a little older than high school. And I'm just saying, like, we have to reach new people. So I was really excited. I gather, though, since we had so many go, I guess the larger group was the protest group. I've actually never been protested before, which is funny because my shows cover all these things that some of which are very racy. But honestly, saying fuck is like the least racy thing I do. So I'm a little flabbergasted. But it is an extemporaneous performance. I don't use a script, so I don't mind like stepping out of course in this crazy circumstance. And I appreciate those of you who have stayed behind. And I promise we'll... this is so heartbreaking. Because you see, it's actually... it's not a script.
I've got a photocopy.
We'll use a photocopy.
Okay.
It's I actually write all my notes on this one original that I keep all these years. And it's actually irreparable. And like tomorrow I'll have to spend all day rewriting it all by hand. That's great. Really?
Okay.
Hmm. Well, we might as well try that.
All right.
I mean, what the fuck else do we have to lose?
All right. There it is.
Thank you. Thanks.
Separate.
Yeah, separate them. That's a good idea. Well, I don't really have their money. I'm an artist. I don't have very much money at all. But I do appreciate your time and attention, and I'm sorry for that. I mean, I'm not responsible, but I'm sorry all the same. And I think what would be best, why don't I just start at the beginning of the second scene? We all heard about my wedding before we poured water all over everything. Everyone remembers that moment. Yes, yes. Apparently that was too much. And it's funny because I imagine a lot of you go to shows in American Repertory Theater, and if I'm not mistaken, like, don't get me wrong, but isn't American Repertory Theater's like primary goal to do shows that are like directed by a Norwegian director that no one's heard of, and it's one guy crawling slowly across the floor, muttering against a white backdrop while blood drips slowly across the stage? And I mean, seriously, if people can deal with that, I mean, if the guy looked up at the end of the crawling and went like, fuck, like, would they all have come up and dumped water on him and run away? That's, wow, it's really something. I don't have much else to say. I actually have a lot to say. So I'll endeavor to pull us back into it. You guys, if you'd like to move down at all, you know, because they freed up a lot of room. If anybody would like to come down, seriously, like, we got room in the whole front, I guess, was them. If anybody would like to come down a little bit, that's really totally cool. I think it's just up here, so I think you're safe. Please come down for a sec. Thanks so much. I'll get my notes together. And you guys good? Okay, people are coming down. That's great. Wow. Well, no. It was really, it's funny, because the monologue's about a bunch of different activities, but it was a little bit, I mean, usually terrorists say what they're doing. I mean, I don't know. There was no statement. They just left. I don't know. I assume I'll have a death threat in my email or something. I have no idea. Yeah, I still saw that. Very proud, very proud. All right. I guess so. I think they've officially start using that adjective as of today, which is funny because I thought that was going to happen after the monologue I do on May 8th, but I guess it starts today. So I'll sit down, and when I do, I mean, I'm not going to but I mean, we'll start up again, so we'll stop this dialogue for a little bit. We'll have a monologue for a while, and then afterwards, anybody wants to talk about what a crazy thing that was. I'll be going to a bar afterwards. I'd be happy to see each and every one of you who stayed through this with me. Thank you again. And now... Is this the right cue now? And I had never dreamed of New York. You know how people do, they can taste